everybody. This is Anthony from Stevie Snacks. And in this free lesson, I'm going to be talking about taking a difficult lick that you're trying to learn, and rather than just trying to get through it and then move on to the next part of the song, identifying places in that lick where you're kind of hitting a speed bump and you kind of interrupt the flow. So we want to take that little section of whatever lick it is, and we want to turn it into a little drill to help you kind of sand out any rough spots. Now, the analogy that I use to explain what we're doing is when you first move to a new city, or if you're just visiting a new city on vacation, you're probably one of those annoying drivers, annoying to everyone who lives there, who drives down the street and you've got to stop and you've got to look at each street sign to, oh, is this the one I want? Is this the one I want? And meanwhile, people who know that area are driving behind you and they're beeping their horn because they don't understand why can't you just go where you're supposed to go. Well, it all comes down to when you're in a new place, you're unsure of where to go, nothing is familiar, so you're stopping at all the wrong places, you're getting in everybody's way, and your playing is kind of the same way. When you do anything enough times on guitar, it kind of gets implanted in your muscle memory to the point where your hand and your fingers, they just work that way without thinking. But sometimes you come across a lick where something is done in a little bit different order than what you're used to. And so at that moment, you're kind of like a person in a new city, because your hands are not, it's like you know you're supposed to move them in that order, but every time you try and do it, your hands, your fingers want to play the notes in the order that you're used to. So what I'm going to talk about today is identifying when that happens, and instead of kind of glossing over it, taking that little thing and turning it into an opportunity to kind of iron out that rough spot, to become more familiar with how it's done in that particular lick so that you can just play it as smoothly as it's supposed to be. The lick that I'm using as an example is a lick from the song Lenny that I was working on with a student here in town, and he had kind of a natural speed bump right here. And then he would continue on to, and there was that little break in there when it's supposed to be smooth. So what we did is we took this very long lick that is what I demonstrated at the beginning, and we turned it into a little drill, which I'll put tabs up for this little drill over at on this lesson page at Stevie Snacks. So if you're unsure of the notes that I'm playing, just go over there and take a look at the tabs. But we made a little drill out of it that goes like this. And so what we did is we identified the notes that were the problem. We kind of stuck those in the middle. And then we just did this repeating thing. And it took them a while because for a while it was, and then remembering to go from here right back into it, it took him some time to kind of get that looping feel. But what happens is that those are all kind of speed bumps that you're ironing out, and you're getting your fingers used to doing this. So one aspect of it is just being used to jumping from one string to the next in an order that you're not used to. Another aspect of it is just simply training your brain to remember that many notes in a row and then being able to repeat it. So the goal is with a drill like this to take something that might not be smooth and turn it into something that you can just play in a circular motion in repeat fashion without any kind of hiccups in it. And so after you master that, now you're ready to kind of move on to the next thing. And instead of knowing a bunch of notes and being able to play them halfway well, you've identified a very difficult spot and you've learned how to play it as smoothly as it was on the record. Now let's talk about a slightly simpler example from a lick that I teach all the time in a lot of different solos and in some of my free lessons. And that's this real standard Stevie Ray Vaughan lick. That's one of the most foundational Stevie Ray Vaughan licks that you'll ever learn. But when you first go to play it, you'll realize that there's a mountain of techniques that go into even the first part. Because, you know, I've got a whole series of DVDs on different techniques. One on this grip, one on bending, one on muting, the raking. And they all kind of go together with even into the first three notes of that lick. So when I hear people play this for the first time, sometimes it'll be, and the timing will be all off. Well, instead of trying to play the whole lick from start to finish, or with hammer-ons, break it down into little chunks and turn them into little drills, like the first three notes. Now that's, frankly, quite annoying, but when you hear it that many times in a row, you start to hear every time you allow this bend to come down, which is part of what makes that lick wrong, if you're not catching this bend. So just working on those three notes. Then work on getting your rake in there. Muting with your palm on the bridge here. Now, you need to work out the little speed bump going from here to that note right there. And if you're going to play it with a hammer on, you need to get used to picking this E string and then immediately hammering on the B string three frets up with your ring finger. So, and you want to focus on getting that note to ring out. Well, now you've got a pull off, so you could turn this into a drill. And maybe the hammer-on's giving you some trouble. So what you can do, and this is something I did with another student that I was working with when I was at the Amp Show in New Jersey. He was having trouble with the hammer-on, so I told him, focus on playing this little drill right here, where all you're doing is picking the high E string, hammering on three frets up on the B string, and then doing a pull-off. So what we've done is we've taken a couple notes out of the middle of that lick and turned them into a little drill. So we've got all these little drills dissecting this one simple lick into these little drills that help you to iron out each part. And then when you get to the hammer-on part, and so you're building up the right kind of strength to do each part of that lick. So the principle that I'm trying to share here is that when you're going through and you're trying to learn a song note for note, when you come across a difficult lick, be aware, like I talked about in the last free lesson, let your ears develop along with your fingers so that you can hear when you're pausing on a note where the person you're trying to learn from isn't. And then take a few notes from before and a few notes after and turn that into a little drill that you can play over and over until you can get it smoothly. You're working out the speed bumps, you're getting familiar with the territory, and soon you'll be able to cruise through there like you've been living there your whole life. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this lesson. I hope it's useful to you. And until next time, thanks for watching.